Hello everyone, Kevin here, and I want to welcome you to this Gobbler's Roost Adventure. Today we're in the town of Arcade, New York, and we're going to be visiting another antique store. This antique store is yesterday and today. Oh, it's a great place. I found many things in this antique store in the past, but we'll see what we can find today. See what they got in the window. Oh, definitely some cool stuff. Look at that traffic light. Anybody need a traffic light for their basement bar? The traffic gets heavy. Oh, some kid had to love that. Maybe another kid will really love it. Oh, this stuff is cool. This stuff is cool. Anybody ever ride an old Schwinn? I know I did when I was a kid. Antiques and collectibles. Let's go in and see what we can find. Like that, not to get political on anybody, but I like that ABC button. Yeah, we'll keep politics out of it. Oh, look at the bone carvings. Those Alaskan bone carvings are cool. That bad service token, I'm gonna have to look at that. I like that old painting. That old painting is neat. Cool Coke sign. Oh, and we find them everywhere we go. Sharp, rusty stuff that my buddy Brian over at Poverty Hill Adventures likes. Oh, here's some fur stretchers. There's three of them. They look kind of old, too. They've been around a while. Let's see. The Who, The Clash, The Ramones, The Velvet Underground, The Sex Pistols. Oh, the guy was a punk rocker. For sure. That is a cool guitar case, no doubt about it. Some old soda bottles. I like it when I find old bottles out in the, when I'm hunting bottle dumps. You never know what you're going to find in an old bottle dump. Oh, wooden nickels. There's one with an Indian on it. Wow. I kind of like that. It's only a dollar. Well, I think I'll take that one. Yeah, that's going to go home with me. Oh, here we go. Here's some decoys. Believe it or not, these old-time decoys are paper mache. And they're made to float on water. They coat them so that they do float on water, but the old decoys like that are made out of paper mache. There's a styrofoam one. There's another paper mache with the broken bill. That's common on those. Bills break out of them a lot. Paper mache with glass eyes. Those are pretty cool. Oh, more bottles. some old Pepsi and 7-Up bottles. There's a Mountain Dew. Here's a couple of cool bottles. Yeah, look at those. Those are cool. Oh. Look at that print. That's pretty cool. Sir William Stewart's Camp in the Rocky Mountains. I don't know who Sir William Stewart was, but that is kind of cool. What else are we going to find? Oh, look at these. My buddy Brian likes snowshoes too, but I think that's the first time that I've ever seen a child's pair of snowshoes. Those are small. Those are definitely made for a child. I did find a little something, John. But actually, there's something over here I want to look at. Could I look at the bad service token?
Oh, punch the display case.
You can't really see it too well, but. Oh. You know what? For my coin collection, I gotta get it. I'll put it with the. Yeah. What else in here is cool? Oh, can I look at the ABC button? You know, I never voted for Clinton, and I know a lot of people hate him, but our economy was great when he was in office. My business did really well when he was in office. $3. I think mostly people hated him just because he was a Democrat.
Yeah.
Well, I think I'm going to pass on that, but it is kind of neat. Oh, that old lock is cool. Yeah. What do you got around this way? Oh, lots of cool stuff. You got a lot of cool stuff in here. That Oldsmobile hood ornament is awesome. You know, what kind of car? Oh, it's a 1950s.
Olds Rocket.
Olds Rocket. Wow. That is cool. Definitely. But them knives look kind of old.
Bayonets are one.
A couple of bayonets.
The one is Civil War.
Uh-huh. Wow.
The other one, don't know the age of. Then we got the old fountain pens, or inkwell pens.
Mm-hmm. Oh, there we go. Some old beer memorabilia. Genesee beer. I love Genesee beer. It's a local beer. What else can we find here? Oh, some household stuff. Oh, look at this. Buffalo Evening News. Oh, wow. Boston's defense. Boston's pesky defense. Number one problem for the Bills. 1968. I was 8 years old. Oh, I think I'm going to have to get this for $1. Go Bills! There's an old Tonka. I don't ever recall seeing an orange Tonka. Wow. Wonder how old that is. That is cool. Some kid had to love that. Tonka Road Grader. Look at that. Almost looks like Popeye. Almost. There's another Tonka. Very cool. It's a camel's saddle. Anybody got a camel you need a saddle for? Jeez. The things you find. I was looking at this old chest when I saw that. The chest is cool. Yeah. Yeah, I was looking at the old chest when I saw the camel saddle. Hey, you could pretend to be Lawrence of Arabia on that thing. An immigrant's trunk.
And it's got, and then on the end, I think it is, has all the we're passed through New York.
Oh, wow.
And I think somewhere it says quarantined.
Oh, wow. I mean, look at the, I didn't even look that closely at it. Wow.
Like 1917, so we're thinking, yeah, whatever that, what was that big plague thing that came through in 1917?
Oh, that was the flu?
Yeah.
That was a flu epidemic that killed many, many people. Wow. I didn't even look that close. That's hand-forged handles on that.
That's what they're thinking. That's why it was quarantined. So they were coming in from, I think it's Germany. It was either 1917 or 1918 when
it is, definitely. It attracted my attention.
The whole thing is all hand-forged. So I understand.
Yeah.
The dovetailed sides. It's,
yeah.
It's a nice piece.
Yeah. The dovetails. Oh, here's an old jitterbug in there. Everybody knows I like jitterbugs. Yep. Very cool. Some old books. Oh, wow. Little Big Man. I remember that movie. Oh, I think I'm going to have to buy this. Yeah, that might be a good read. Cool. That'll go home with me. See what else we can find in here. Buffalo Sabres, my favorite hockey team. Anybody like classic cars? Old oil can. All right, from the Buffalo Sabres to Hall of Famer Jim Kelly. Led the Bills to 4 Super Bowls. It's a shame they should have won at least one of them. They deserved it. Well, here we go again. Buffalo Bills, go Bills! Oh, more bottles. Old fish bottle. Those are old wine bottles. The fish bottles are. Go through this. Oh. Yeah, that describes me pretty well. Yep. What do we got here? Oh, Chief Corn Planter. Wow. Davy Crockett. That is cool. Yeah. I don't know why, but that's going to go home with me. Go this way. Oh, look at that. old newspaper. Oh, just to be fair, we showed the Clinton thing. Real like Bush in 92. Some old photographs. There's another old decoy up there. Old padlocks. What do we got here? Old cowbell. Oh, very cool. Some old pipes. Back in the day, everybody smoked one of those. Old clay pipe. Very cool. Go back here. Wood plane. Go back here and look at these bottles. Take a second peek at them. Old pipes, they're cool. If I smoke some tobacco, I'd be getting one of them. Oh, very cool old decoy. Made on a copying lathe. You can tell by the ridges that it was made by some sort of copying lathe. There's another decoy. Old wooden working decoy. He's pretty cool. Glass eyes. He's cool, definitely. Oh, I probably say that too much. But cool stuff is cool stuff, no matter what. Get all these bottles. Oh, Genesee ginger ale. I live right near the Genesee River. Some old antique cars. What else we got down there? Old wooden spoon. There's another one. And another one. I like the wooden spoons. Because I make wooden spoons. Those are cool. Those are old. Very cool. Oh. There's another old wooden spoon. Fork. Yeah, the reason I look at this stuff is because if you go to rendezvous, this is the kind of stuff you need to eat at the camp feast. You need to use these to eat. They won't let you use modern stuff. Everybody uses a three-prong fork. Very cool stuff. Old screwdriver. Oh, yeah, definitely neat stuff. Period correct, that's what they call it. The old oil lamps are always cool. I like that one. That one's nice.
So
So there you have it, folks. I thought I'm back from my little visit to the antique store yesterday and today in Arcade, New York. And, I got a couple of small things. I didn't really make any major purchases this time. It's a great store. I find good things there quite often. But today, what I bought was, I live in a small town southeast of Buffalo, so I bought this 1968 Buffalo News. The reason I bought it, because it talks about the Buffalo Bills. Go Bills! Yeah. And a couple other small things I got. I don't know who remembers. If you ever saw the motion picture Little Big Man with Dustin Hoffman and Faye Dunaway. It was a pretty cool movie. And I bought the book. I'm not positive, but I think there was a real person called Little Big Man. Maybe this book will enlighten me a little more. But I think I'm going to enjoy this book, Little Big Man. It was a pretty cool movie from, I think it was from the 70s. If you haven't seen it, check it out. It's not your typical cowboy movie, but it was pretty cool. I think I'm going to enjoy this book. And I don't know why, but I bought this Boy Scout patch, mostly because it says Davy Crockett on it. Thought that was kind of cool. And ever since I was a little boy, I've collected pennies and coins and stuff like that. And, I thought this was a really cool wooden nickel. It's got an Indian on it. And it says, "Don't take wooden nickels." A lot of times these wooden nickels are beer tokens, which I have a collection of beer tokens. This one isn't, but still it will go with my collection of wooden nickels. Another one I bought that I thought was really cool was this aluminum bad tip token. On one side, it says, "Give nothing, get nothing." And on the other side, it says, "0 cents. This coin is your tip. It matches exactly the value of your service." 0 cents. Now, you got to be a pretty miserly person to be giving something like this out. But I bought it because it is pretty darn cool. And those are my purchases for today. I hope you enjoyed our little visit to yesterday and today in Arcade, New York. If you did, please subscribe to my channel, Gobbler's Roost Adventures, and also hit the like button. I'm Kevin, and I want to thank you for stopping by.